Hi, I'm Tony, and today I'm going to show you how to perform an offline pH calibration using the Calibration Portavo 907 Multi portable meter with Memosens sensors. The primary benefit of using Memosens digital sensors with a portable meter is that the calibration data is stored within the sensor head and not in the transmitter. This allows us to perform an offline calibration in an environment and at a time that's convenient to the operator. No more calibrating pH sensors in bad weather, at inopportune times, or in hazardous areas. Now, let's take a look at the items we need to perform our calibration, and we'll walk you through the process. To perform a calibration, you will need the Portavo 907 Multi portable meter, a Memosens Portavo cable, a Memosens pH sensor, at least two buffer solutions with clean containers to pour them in, rinsing water, and finally a clean cloth for drying the sensor. Before you begin the calibration process, you must connect the Memosens Portavo cable to the portable meter and then to the sensor. Turn the Portavo on and make sure that the setup and configuration of the portable meter has been performed. This can be verified by pressing the measure button twice to ensure that the date and time are correct. If this is incorrect, please watch our Portavo 907 Multi setup and configuration video before performing your calibration. Memosens sensor information can be exported and used for diagnostics. To start the calibration process, press the upper left button to go into the main menu screen on the Portavo. Then, navigate to the calibration menu and select Enter. There are three options for the cal mode. We recommend calmatic or automatic calibration with at least 2 points of calibration. In calmatic mode, buffer solutions are automatically recognized and compensated based on the temperature reading from the integrated temperature detector. You'll see that once you've selected calmatic under the calibration mode, it then offers us the ability to select which buffer set we are using. When using calmatic mode, the Portavo is preset with 10 common buffer sets to choose from. All are pre-programmed with temperature compensation tables. It should be noted the most common buffer on the market is NIST Technical. You can verify your buffer set by checking the labeling on your bottles. Next, press the upper right button to start the process. The calibration process on the Portavo 907 Multi is very intuitive and straightforward. It prompts you to dip the sensor in the first buffer solution. With automatic calibration, it does not matter which buffer solution you start the process with. I will begin our calibration using a buffer 7. I'm using the Calimat buffers, which utilize an integrated dosing cup on the top of the bottle for single dose usage. If you're not using Calibration Calimat buffers, put your buffer in a separate container for accurate calibration and to prevent cross-contamination. It's recommended to use fresh buffer solution for each calibration to ensure accuracy. To begin the process, dip the sensor in the first buffer solution and stir lightly. The junction on the sensor needs to be fully immersed in the buffer, covering about 1 inch of the sensor. It's also very important to let the values on the top of your Portavo screen stabilize. Once the values have stabilized, press the continue button. After pressing the continue button, the Portavo checks the drift of the first buffer solution. As you can see, it displays the millivolt output generated by the sensor in the first buffer solution, as well as the measured temperature value. The Portavo automatically indicates a buffer value of 7.00 based on the millivolt output of the sensor. Once it is finished with the first buffer solution, the Portavo then prompts us to go ahead and dip the sensor in the second buffer. You'll now want to rinse the sensor with a cleaning solution such as distilled water prior to putting it in the second buffer solution. Then dab it dry, being very careful not to rub the glass bulb. Now, repeat the process in the second buffer. Once again, stir lightly and make sure the junction is completely immersed. It's very important that the pH and temperature value stabilize before you press continue. Once the values have stabilized, we can go ahead and press the continue button on the Portavo. The meter will now check the drift of the second buffer, automatically indicating its value and again displaying the millivolt and temperature. Once the process is finalized, you can see that the Portavo provides a summary of the results of the calibration. In the top left corner, there is a smiley face indicating that our calibration is good. The specific values of the calibration are also indicated. The zero point, the slope, and also the response time of our sensor. Finally, there is a pictograph above these values indicating the 2 points that we used during our calibration procedure. Here you can see the arrows indicating the buffer values of 4 and 7 that were used. We can now press apply, which writes the calibration data to the Memosens sensor head, or discard to begin the process again. This completes the offline calibration process of our Memosens pH sensor. As you can see, the entire procedure took less than 2 minutes and was done conveniently right here in our workshop. This sensor can now be stored on the shelf with the rest of our pre-calibrated Memosens sensors. It's now ready for field exchange at a moment's notice. Thank you for watching.